A group of foreign workers protests outside of a Lebanon County food packaging plant. It's our top story in the first 11 at 11. The workers are here under the premise of a student cultural exchange program. They walked off their jobs in protest at the XL plant, a Hershey-owned distribution facility in North Londonderry Township. Here's 8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger.
A loud protest, lots of police, and in the end, 3 people arrested as dozens of foreign workers participating in an educational exchange program walked off of the job at a plant where employees package Hershey's candy in Lebanon County, saying the experience they're having isn't what they signed up for.
I pick up boxes which are 40 pounds. I am 95 pounds. How can I put up? If I don't do it, supervisors come to me and say, I will send you home.
I am aching in every possible place, so my first thought is just to get into bed and sleep.
Most of the foreign workers are students ranging from 18 to 26 years old. They hold J-1 visas and have paid to participate in a program that's designed to teach them what it's like to live and work in America. Instead, they tell News 8 they have little contact with Americans, the work leaves them exhausted, and their average $8 an hour wage barely covers housing and food bills.
If it's just from what I've seen, it's somewhere nobody should come to.
The factory where we are working, it's not a place for cultural exchange.
This is immoral.
Supporters of organized labor joined the students' effort Wednesday, including 3 union leaders who were eventually arrested for trespassing during the protest.
Their experience of America is America within the 4 walls of a factory, in a subcontracted company, and in the heart of a company town. That's not the America they came to experience.
Saket Soni heads the National Guest Worker Alliance and says he's sympathetic to the workers' complaints and further argues the factory jobs the students have should be filled with local workers instead of foreign students.
These student workers are actually on strike demanding that these jobs be turned into living wage jobs for their neighbors, for Pennsylvanians.
Now, the head of the Council for Educational Travel USA, the group which helped to bring these workers to the U.S. for this program, tells News 8, quote, it is likely that some of those students do not even realize to what extent they are being exposed to America. He went on to explain the workers were fully briefed on what their work and living assignments would be like, and in his eyes, Ron, this program is operating as it should.
Clearly a difference of opinion here.
That's right.
All right. Thank you, Matt. Mm-hmm.